this, yeah, we're gonna be doing those. All right, so here's what we're gonna be doing today. I saw this online, I thought it was really cool. We're also doing it for Smosh's second channel, Smosh Labs. I'm sure you've seen this as a kid. You lit these like little fireworks, and there was the ones that you lit, and then they like created like this like little snake thing, right? And like it created this black snake. Well, today we're gonna be doing an experiment to basically replicate that, but on a bigger scale. So we're gonna be making like a carbon snake out of these ingredients down here. So baking soda, powdered sugar. This is kind of just, you know, as our base, and then we're gonna use this as our fuel source. So I've never done this. I guess we're just gonna, you know, get into it. Let's see what happens. This kind of reminds me of Uhas, cornstarch. What a story that was. Well, it calls for a 1-to-4 ratio. How do they feel about a 1-to-2? I feel like a drug dealer. This is some good fine cut mixing right here. We only cut it to a 1-to-3 ratio, so it's pretty pure. And I'm not gonna put it in my mouth and taste, because baking soda in your mouth tastes disgusting. Yep. Yep, gross. Stir stick. Okay, I'm gonna make a little divot for where we're gonna put our stuff. It's like a volcano. Okie dokie. Ladder up. The volcano is erupting. Okay, I guess we're gonna sit back and watch this thing grow now. Well, it's definitely on fire, that's for sure. I mean, that's why we do this. That's why we do this, you know? Always gotta test them before we do it for Smosh, because, well, I mean, this isn't exactly what I expected, so. I think for once we went too big. I think we're gonna have to try this again on a smaller scale, which I hate doing. I hate scaling anything down. Or adding more fuel. So it's kind of like, you know, one or the other. Really gonna get a lot of it this time. Really soak that sand. It's not happening. It's just not happening the way that we had anticipated. Well, I learned that we've been doing it wrong the entire time. So hopefully we're gonna set that straight and do it right. First things first, we're gonna do a 4-to-1 ratio, not the other way around. So we're gonna do one baking soda. Making a nice little cake here, nice little happy volcano. With a nice little flame. It's gonna be real nice and grow a nice little snake. Wow, immediately different.
Whoa.
It's working though, that's good. Apparently, the more sugar you add, the more like snake-like it is. So we'll do one bigger and then we'll do another one snake-like. It smells sweet.
It does. Burning sugar, like creme brulee.
Yeah.
Creme brulee.
It's a science creme brulee. It's kind of like the Doritos thing, you know? It's like, it's a carbon source, so it burns. And it's just, you know, oxygen plus the carbon source equals CO2 and water.
Holy
okay, yeah, so that kind of freaked me out a little bit.
Burning sand.
Yeah.
Burning Sanders. There you were.
Whoa, look at the little ones. It's actually working.
What?
That's hilarious. It's working and we're not even trying for it to work. Just so everybody knows, I just lit the sand on fire just because I said it was so wet that I thought like maybe there was so much butane in it that like I could just light it off. And it's actually doing the thing that we've been trying to do all day.
What you're seeing is actually a three-part reaction. First, the sugar burns and turns into water vapor and CO2. Second, the sugar goes through thermal decomposition and gives us carbon and more water vapor. Third, the baking soda, or sodium bicarbonate, is heated and turns into sodium carbonate, CO2, and water vapor. The result? Our sugar burns, making carbon, which in turn gets fluffed by the CO2 from the heated baking soda, creating a growing black snake. There's technically some sodium carbonate in the snake as well, but it's mostly made of carbon from the sugar.
Whoa.
Okay, I like that one.
Keep going, bro. Keep going. That one's doing great. That's the best one we've ever seen so far.
It's definitely still growing. This time around, I took the baking soda powdered sugar mix and I put it into a paper towel cloth, almost like a packet, I guess you could say. And we put it down into the sand.
And then we lit the sand and we got that.
So that's the best that we've gotten all day long. It still smells like marshmallows. Smells like marshmallows, smells great. I'm fascinated by how this works because we haven't really hacked it yet. But I mean, it's successful, we've done it. That's really cool. It looks really cool. We've done the experiment, right? We've gotten it, but I just don't know how it's been. I don't know how to control it yet. If you guys like this video, go ahead and give us a thumbs up. In the comment section below, let me know, were you surprised that just the sugar and the baking soda by itself created this mixture of which I still think personally it looks like a ram's horn. I don't know about a snake. I think it actually looks very similar to a ram's horn. If there's something, some other thing that you think that it looks like that I'm totally missing, let me know. Cause I'd be really interested in about what you guys see. It's kind of one of those diagrams of what do you see? And you're like, oh, that's Nick Uhas. That's what I see. So if you do, that'd be great. But let me know in the comment section below. And as always, don't forget to subscribe because we have new videos every Tuesday and Friday, and we'll see you really soon.